fascism in Italy. Between the two world wars, that means the period between 1918 to 1939, Europe lived under the shadow of wars. Though World War I was stopped for namesake, and thousands of treaties were arranged between the European countries, peace was not fully achieved. Along with the countries involved in the war, neutral countries also affected by the war. League of Nations, which was founded for achieving international peace, could satisfy only few big nations. Even those nations were not happy due to the Great Economic Depression. Common people longed for change in the governments. All over the Europe, people hesitated against the then existing governments. People in severe despair believed in dictators. In such situation, a dictator named Mussolini earned popular support. According to Mussolini, there is nothing important than the state. All within the state, nothing outside the state, nothing against the state. So it was the opinion of Mussolini. And some other popular opinions of Mussolini are, in his view, there is no room for individual freedom. The purpose of individual existence is nothing but serving the state. State is everything. One should not question the state. Religion, morality, and education should serve the purpose of the state. Democracy is beautiful in theory. In practice, it is a fallacy. Socialism is a fraud, a comedy, a phantom, blackmail. It is good to trust others, but not to do so is much better. We become strong, I feel, when we have no friends upon whom to lean or to look for moral guidance. So these are the opinions of Mussolini. Fascism. The word fascism derived from Roman word fascis, which means bundle of firewood. In ancient Rome, a bundle of firewood and an axe were carried before a judge. Bundle of firewood represents unity and the axe symbolizes power. Dictatorial governments are called fascist governments. Benito Mussolini's government in Italy and Hitler's government in Germany come under this category. Fascism is a form of government which is a type of one-party dictatorship. Fascists are against democracy. They work for a totalitarian one-party state. This aim is to prepare the nation for armed conflict and to respond to economic difficulties. It stands for a centralized government headed by a dictator. Most of the great patriots were from middle class. Youth wanted to control the communism. Even by using force, youth wanted to control communism in Italy. Fascists wore black shirts, so they were called the Black Shirts Army. Black Shirts were a voluntary army. Three principles of Black Shirts. State should have absolute power. Private property should be safeguarded. With an affecting foreign policy, Italy should be made an international power. Benito Mussolini and Fascism. The theorist of fascism was Benito Mussolini, as he was influenced by the socialist ideals. To avoid compulsory military service, Mussolini fled to Switzerland. In Switzerland, he worked for a socialist newspaper. In Switzerland, Mussolini united the laborers and led few agitations. Due to this reason, he was banned from Switzerland. Same thing happened in Austria also. Mussolini returned to Italy and acted as an editor for Avanti, a newspaper. Mussolini did quit socialism when his suggestion to involve Italy in World War I was rejected by the socialists. Mussolini founded a newspaper named Popoli Due Italian. Poverty, unemployment, and hesitations were increased after World War I. Mussolini rightly used this opportunity and founded nationalist groups by name fascists. In 1921, Mussolini was elected as a member of parliament and started convincing about the necessity of military dictatorship. On 27th October 1922, when the existing government in Italy lost confidence of public, Victor Emmanuel II, King of Italy, invited Mussolini to form government. On 31st October 1922, Mussolini became President of Italy. Power was concentrated in the hands of fascist Grand Council. Opposition governments and the press were banned. Mussolini as the Premier of Italy. Mussolini ended robbers in Naples and Sicily. He improved the socio-economic status of laborers. At most, loyal persons were appointed to the important offices. He changed the election procedure and took care that fascists have at least a 2/3 majority in the parliament. Only fascists were allowed to practice law. In 1924 elections, fascists secured majority of the seats. Mussolini took care that people get good administration. King remained for namesake. Police was given full powers. In 1926, all the political parties were banned and opposition party leaders were arrested. Mussolini developed economy, industries, transport and education. Mussolini introduced compulsory education system. He took measures to eradicate corruption. All the facilities were provided to common people. Thus, he won the consensus of majority of the Italians. Italian economy. Italy was in severe economic depression by the time Mussolini came to power. Excess unemployment was there. For the creation of employment opportunities, Mussolini started education institutions, constructed roads, guest houses, dams, bridges, and shipbuilding, and successfully provided jobs to unemployed. By the year 1926, Mussolini achieved balanced budget. He cleared all the foreign debts. After 1930, Mussolini reduced the wages of employees. Agriculture development. Mussolini planned to reduce the dependency on foreign countries by increasing agriculture production. Wheat, cotton, tobacco, rice, barley, maize production was increased. He gave slogan of a war for wheat to increase the production of wheat. Prizes were given to the farmers who produced more wheat. He encouraged agriculture cooperative societies and founded banks to give agriculture loans. Agriculture education was given to the farmers. To discourage the imports of wheat, in 1933, Mussolini increased duty on wheat imports. Through this measure, he increased the agriculture production and reduced foreign exchange deficiency. Industrial development. Though Italy was full of hills, it was rich in minerals. He realized that there is no scope for industrial development and concentrated on expanding already existing industries. Industrialists were given long-term loans. To overcome the scarcity of coal, he concentrated on hydropower. Mussolini encouraged the factories which manufactured trains, ships, aeroplanes, motors, and engines. For the superiority in naval power, subsidies were given to shipbuilders. Sea routes were developed to Balkan, Turkey, Soviet Union, Egypt, India. Italy reached to the position of exporting warships to other nations. Incentives were given to the producers of silk, rayon, Mussolini reduced the laborers' working hours. He achieved the stability of prices. Thus, Mussolini's policy achieved self-sufficiency in industrial production. To avoid class struggle, Mussolini founded syndicates all over the state with national parties, capitalists, laborers as members. Education system. Free and compulsory education was given to kids below 14 years. Mussolini taught fascist principles in schools. Students were inducted into fascist People's Army when they attained the age of 18. This army came to be called as a fascist militia. Treaty with Pope. This treaty was famous as a Lateran Treaty, and this treaty was concluded on 11th February 1929. Mussolini planned to avoid bad influence of church and the state. To achieve this, he wanted to keep religion under the state control. For this, he concluded Lateran Treaty with Pope. He introduced religious education in schools and accepted to pay the wages of religious heads. Mussolini wanted to restore the last pride of Roman Catholic Church by territorial expansion. Fascists considered aggression on other countries as patriotism and pride to Italy. Mussolini's colonial policy. Mussolini planned for acquiring colonies. In a bid to occupy Tunisia, Corsica Islands, Mussolini lost good terms with France. Mussolini concentrated on Eastern Europe. Capturing of Ethiopia was one of the important victories of Mussolini. In 1935, by occupying Abyssinia, he came closer to Germany. It paved way for Rome-Berlin axis. During the Second World War, Italy joined on the side of Germany and proclaimed war on England and France. Initially, Italy lost its colonies, and finally, Italy got defeated by Britain. Italians started despising Mussolini. Popular support started increasing to the opponents of Mussolini. Germany influenced the release of Mussolini when he got arrested many times. Finally, Italian nationalists assassinated Mussolini at Dongo. Though Mussolini was a dictator, he was an enlightened despot. Mussolini developed Italy. It was his foreign policy which ended his life.